Hello there, everybody, and welcome to my channel. Victoria here at Radiant Moon Tarot. We've got your daily reading here today for Monday, February 19th of 2024. If you're new to my channel, hello and welcome to you. If you're returning, welcome back. I'm always grateful for every single one of you. Let's have a look and see what we've got coming out for you guys today. As I'm shuffling here, a couple of housekeeping items. I do have some timeless readings, messages from the universe posted for you. And the last one's coming out Sunday afternoon. So if you see this reading on Sunday, Aquarius and Pisces are still coming out, but everything else is already posted. If you're seeing this Monday, then everything is already up for you guys. So this is just messages all about you, whatever spirit wants you to know right now. Also your weekly readings, it's another choose your deck. People seem to enjoy that. So your weekly readings for the week are also posted. And so I will put the description or the link, excuse me, in the description box down below. Bottom of the deck we've got for Monday, we've got the star, some beautiful Aquarian energy. Now the Aquarian energy of the star does bring in an element of serendipity. So this is where you may find some peaceful resolutions today, or you may feel that things are all falling into place. There could be a little bit of calm after a storm for some of you, but this also does bring blessings and miracles to you. The star card is a big yes card. Dream big, wish big, keep your hopes alive, and really kind of harness all of the power and the energy that the universe has to offer. You attract abundance to you when we've got the star energy. Star does bring about an element of balance and healing to your situation there as well. So, you know, focus on resolving things in a peaceful way. If you are feeling tired and drained, then this is a reminder to take care of yourself. But ultimately, we have a potential here to manifest our wishes and dreams, right? Really bring them into fruition, bring them into reality. So some of you are really harnessing your inner magic this week. So really focus on that. Of course, the star can also bring us, again, some hope and inspiration for the future. So it may just be a day for you where you're a lot more positive than maybe you were previously. The main energy coming in for you, we do have the Three of Swords here today. So that's important that the star is at the back of the deck there, because the underlying energy is a healing element, right? Is a restoration of hope, the feeling that everything is going to be okay. So with the Three of Swords, there may be something going on that doesn't quite go your way, or maybe you're recognizing something that you need to work through, something that you need to heal from, because ultimately the Aquarian energy that does come in brings us freedom and helps us to release things, right? So release things that are holding us back. So the Three of Swords, yes, there may be something in your current day that doesn't quite go your way, right? And something that maybe something is positive but not quite what you wanted. This can be something that is negative and challenging for you, right? But the important thing is just to honor your emotions and to work through. Because when we do get the Three of Swords, yes, it's known as a broken heart kind of energy, but it's also an opportunity to heal and to work through something. One thing to remember with the Three of Swords, it is a temporary energy and it is not something that lingers around for too long, provided we do kind of, you know, work through it a little bit and recognize and acknowledge it. So the star influence at the back of the deck here is really bringing in a positive vibe to your day, even if something doesn't go your way. We've got the Two of Wands coming here for you guys as well. Now, this is your blessings position. So this is the energy benefiting you the most today. So the Two of Wands, this really does have you clearing blocks and obstacles, making some plans, making some decisions, looking out into the future and recognizing that, hey, the coast is clear, right? So maybe you're making some plans for the future. Maybe you're making some plans for your week. And with the Two of Wands right beside the Three of Swords, perhaps something that you planned doesn't quite go your way, but with the Two of Wands here in your blessings position, it's like, that's okay. So it could be that, you know, you turn a negative into a positive, that if you had a certain way that you wanted your day to go, or that you wanted to start out your week and it's not quite getting off on that foot, this is the ability there to clear the air, clear the path and turn things back around again. So the Two of Wands, also a big picture thinking, where the Three of Swords is a little bit more centered and closed off. So this can be, again, where you are shifting your energy into something a little bit bit more positive and into something a little bit more, how should we say, open-minded, right? And so sometimes that's really the way forward, all right? It could also be that you're waiting for something here with the Two of Wands. It's like, okay, I know what I want. I'm feeling good about things. I have an open door for something, but there could be a little element of frustration. Things aren't happening fast enough, or you haven't quite found what it is you're looking for yet, whether it's just something minor or whether it's something a little bit bigger, right? So this might be just something that you need to work through. Your challenge for your day ahead, because we need an extra one on the Three of Swords, right? We've got the Queen of Wands here for you. So, you know, with the Queen of Wands, this can be an energy here where, you know, maybe you had expected to do something with somebody. You had expected to spend some time with a person perhaps, and instead of working with somebody, having some support or meeting someone, right? Maybe you got some plans. And instead it's like, oh, now I gotta go solo, or now I gotta do this on my own. Usually the Queen of Wands is a very positive energy, very positive card, but it is an independent energy as well. So if you had your sights set on doing something with somebody, right, and having a little bit of help, then you might find yourself kind of working alone, okay, or doing something by yourself, right? Would this throw you in the Three of Swords energy? It most likely would, right? But can you turn it around and find the positive? Yes, you can. Because even though the Queen of Wands is in the challenge position, okay, this is showing you that whatever life happens to, whatever curveballs happen to get thrown your way today, you can persevere and you can get things done and you will be okay, right? So it's like a temporary knock of your confidence, perhaps. With the Three of Wands here also, or the Queen of, why do I keep saying Three of Wands? I don't know. I mean, maybe the advice from Spirit is the Three of Wands. Anyways, I keep calling the Queen of Wands the Three of Wands. So perhaps there is something here that you really do want to get off the ground, and something that you were really excited about, but it's not working out the way that you wanted it to. But anyways, the Queen of Wands, geez, I did it again. The Queen of Wands in your challenge can represent that maybe you've got some issue with a person in your life. The Queen of Wands quite often does come out as like a best friend kind of energy, right? Someone that you kind of enjoy their company, you like to be around them. So it may be that they're not in exactly the best of moods today. You might have been expecting a phone call or something and you might not get it. So even though it's still in the upright, it's still a relatively positive energy, but there is some obstacle, challenge, some situation, something that we've got to work through with this person. So maybe someone's just feeling a little lazy today as well, okay? So just kind of be aware of that not everybody may be in the best of moods today, and you may have some plans that might go a little awry, but you can get things back on track. We've got the Eight of Swords there, and that is your advice from Spirit, freedom. Right? The Eight of Swords is a very restrictive kind of energy. And this is kind of where, you know, we kind of get wrapped up in a little ball. We're quite often not seeing something because we're too focused on something, or we've got a blindfold on. This is quite often where we also are stuck on an idea, or we're kind of wrapped up in a little bit of fear, right? Something here is restricting you today, and it's quite often matters of the mind, right? So there is something here that you do need to release, that you do need to work through, and that you need to find your way forward from. But remember, we've got the Two of Wands coming in there, and this is you breaking free out of this restrictive kind of energy, restrictive way of thinking, and opening your mind, right? Quite often that Eight of Swords is a restrictive way of thinking. I can't do that, or there's nothing, no opportunities there for me, or oh man, my plans went to crap today, now what do I do, right? So we're getting out of that kind of mindset, that kind of way of thinking, and we're opening our mind, and instead we're taking a negative or taking a challenge and turning it into a positive today. And that is your advice from Spirit. Okay, maybe it's even a matter of getting out of your mind and into your heart. That can be very, very powerful in its energy as well. Some of you may be really working through something, and you're getting ready to face your fears as well. So maybe there's a conversation that you need to have with somebody, and this is like getting you all wrapped up in knots, feeling a little bit anxious, right? Because quite often if we have to have a conversation with somebody, or we need to clear the air, or maybe we need to ask for forgiveness, right? Or, you know, whatever it happens to be, resolve some issues. Sometimes we do kind of hesitate on that a little bit because we're not 100% sure always how someone is going to be responding. And considering the Queen of Wands can be a very good friend, or maybe even a business associate of some kind, right? This can be maybe that conversation that is necessary to move something forward, or just clear up some misunderstanding, clear the air. Honesty and truth will always set you free, but we've got to maybe take some steps, right? We've got to maybe put ourselves out there a little bit, and being vulnerable is not always easy for a lot of people, but this might be the position that you need to put yourself through, because that way you can kind of get rid of the little black cloud that might be over your head a little bit here. And remember, we do have the serendipitous energy of the star. So I'm going to leave that there for you guys. I hope there was something here for you today. Whatever your situation is, Queen of Wands, remember, you are confident, you are powerful, you are brave, and you are strong, even though sometimes you don't quite feel like it. All right. So I hope you guys have a great day. If you enjoyed your reading, please do hit that like button there. I truly appreciate that. It does help my channel out. It's free for you, and it's just one flick of your finger, but it does help the video get seen, which is a dog-eat-dog world out there these days. All right. So thank you guys. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.